Next, in this one, he may ask the find the area of the triangle. They may ask find the area of the triangle whose adjacent sides are given by A bar and B bar. A bar and B bar. That means, for example, if you go for the a triangle. Now this is the consider. This is the triangle, and this is the point A, B, and C. Now what they are given? Adjacent sides are A bar, comma B bar. Consider this only point. This is the A bar and B bar. They are given the adjacent side. Consider this angle is the theta. Now usually what you know the area of the triangle? Half into base into height. Half into base into height we know. Now here observe what we can find the area means from this triangle. If it is angle theta be the angle between the vectors A bar and B bar from this triangle, what you are going to get now? Sin theta you are going to get CD by AB, opposite side by hypotenuse. Now that is nothing but what is the CD? CD is equal to AB sin theta. What is the AB? AB nothing but magnitude of the vector AB bar sin theta. Okay, now come to the usual formula. Delta ABC is equal to what you know? Half into base into height. Now that is nothing but half into base into height. Now here AC, not AB, this side is the AC. No? Now half into AB into CD. AB means AB bar modulus of CD means modulus of AC bar sin theta. Therefore here observe there what you are going to get. Delta n cap is equal to half into modulus of AB bar modulus of AC bar and sin theta into n cap. Now what you are going to get, this one is the half into AB cross AC, half into AB cross AC, where this is called as vector area of the triangle. Find the vector area of the triangle means you have to show the this one. Find the vector area of the angle. But the actual area of the angle, what you are going to get, observe there. Now here you are going to get the area of the angle is by taking the modulus on both sides. That is delta is equal to half into modulus of AB cross AC. And here further what you are going to get, here this one only multiplication. And here you are going to get taking modulus on both sides, half into AB cross AC. Half into AB cross AC means what you know? Half into AB bar is the A bar and AC bar is the B bar. This is the usually to find the area of the triangle. Okay. Once again I am explaining, you have observed there. Here AC, A bar comma B bar be the adjacent sides of the triangle. Then find the area of the triangle means. Now if it is from the triangle, this is AD be the perpendicular, that is altitude. Now from this triangle ACD, sin theta is equal to CD by AC. CD by AC. Now this is if you take cross multiplication, CD is equal to AC into sin theta. AC nothing but magnitude of the vector AC bar. Therefore modulus of AC bar sin theta. Now usually what you know, delta ABC is equal to half into AB into CD, that is half into base into height. AB nothing but distance between the AB, that is nothing but modulus of AB bar, and this is the CD nothing but modulus of AC sin theta. Now multiplying with the delta n cap. Now what you got? Half into AB bar into AC, AB modulus of AB bar modulus of AC bar sin theta n cap. This is nothing but AB cross AC, AB cross AC, half into AB cross AC. This is called as vector area of the triangle. For the taking modulus on both sides, you are going to get half into AB cross AC, and this is the area of the triangle. Similarly, we can derive the area of the parallelogram, and area of the parallelogram whose adjacents are given by, if it is the parallelogram, if they are given, adjacent sides are A bar and B bar, then what you are going to get? Directly modulus of A bar cross B bar, modulus of A bar cross B bar, you are going to get the area of the parallelogram. Further, so many the vector multiplication holds distributive law on addition, that is A cross B bar plus C bar is equal to A cross B plus A cross C. Should remember, this is the basic properties of the cross multiplication. And further, we have to observe. We have observed one example. I am taking only all the things in only one example here. What I am taking observe there here in only one example I am taking is given a bar. What they are given a bar? For example, if you consider a bar is equal to here. What they are taking observe there? I am taking here 2i plus j. 2i plus j plus 3k. And b bar, what I am taking observe there? B bar I am taking as 3i plus 5j minus 2k. Now first I am finding here a bar cross b bar. A bar cross b bar. A bar cross b bar means usually don't go for the formula, directly go for the modulus, that is I cap, j cap and k cap. And here what you are going to get here, observe there 2, 1, 3 and further 3, 5, minus 2. 3, 5, minus 2. Minus 3, 5, minus 2. Now expand this. If you are expanded this one, what you are going to get? I cap into minus 2, minus 15. Minus j cap into here, minus 4, minus 9. Plus k cap into 10 minus 3. That means finally, what you are going to get? A bar cross B bar is equal to, you are going to get minus 17i plus 13j plus 7k. Now, he may ask, find the modulus of A bar cross B bar. Modulus of A bar cross B bar means, same thing, find the modulus of A bar cross B bar. Modulus of A bar cross B bar is equal to root of minus 17 whole square plus 13 square plus 7 square, that you are going to get root of 507. And further, you may ask, find the sine theta, sine of the angle between them. Find the sine of the angle between them. That means, what is the formula we have? Sine theta is equal to modulus of A bar cross B bar by modulus of A bar into modulus of B bar. That is, you have to find out that one. Modulus of A bar, if you find that, what you are going to get? Modulus of the A bar, 2 square, 4 plus 1 plus 9 is equal to root 14. And modulus of B bar, what you are going to get? 3 square plus 5 square minus 2 square minus 2 whole square become plus 4. Now finally you are going to get this one is the 38. Therefore sin theta is equal to what you are going to get? Root of 507 by root of 14 into root of 38. Finally you are going to get root of 507 by 532. If possibilities are there, you can reduce this one. And same thing they may ask, find the area of the triangle whose adjacent sides are given. This one, whose adjacent sides are given means what you can write? Area of the triangle means delta is equal to half into A bar cross B bar. That is nothing but half into root of 507 square units. Otherwise, he may ask, find the area of the parallelogram. Area of the parallelogram. Directly, what do you know? A bar cross B bar, area of the parallelogram means. Then what is the answer? Root of 507 square units. You may ask, find the unit vector perpendicular to both A bar and B bar. Already we have studied, what is the A bar and B bar? Here this is the A bar, this is the B bar, means this is the N bar, N cap. What is that? The unit vector perpendicular to both A bar and B bar. Both A bar and B bar. That's why here what I am taking observe, N cap is equal to what you know? Now, A bar cross B bar by modulus of A bar cross B bar. Now A bar cross B bar, what you got now in this previously? Minus 17i plus 13j plus 7k. Now by root of 507. If you want to expand, you can write the 17 minus 17 by root of 507i plus 13 by root of 507j and plus 7 by root of 507k. Okay, this is maybe asked like this. Further, he may ask you another one. For example, is given A bar is equal to I plus J plus K and B bar is equal to I plus 2J plus 3K. And he may ask the vector perpendicular to both A bar plus B bar, comma A bar minus B bar. That means just have to find A bar plus B bar. If you find the A plus bar, B plus A bar plus B bar, what you are going to get? A bar plus B bar, you are going to get 2i plus 3j plus 4k. And A bar minus B bar, what you are going to get? A bar minus B bar, a bar minus b bar means ii gets cancelled, minus j minus 2k. Now the vector perpendicular to both a bar and b bar means a bar cross b bar by modulus of a bar cross b bar. Now here both perpendicular to means instead of a you have written a plus b, instead of b you have written the c. But for the our convenience I am writing c bar. Let c bar is equal to a bar plus b bar cross a bar minus b bar. Now if you solve this one by product method, what you are going to get? Det of I j k, and you have to write these, what you are getting? 2, 3, 4, 0, minus 1, minus 2. If you expanded this one, you are going to get C bar is equal to what you are going to get? Minus 2i plus 4j minus 2k you are going to get. Hence, required vector. What is this required vector? The vector perpendicular to both A bar and B bar. No. Therefore, C cap is equal to modulus C bar by modulus C bar. Substitute. Finally, you may get C cap is equal to minus 1 by root 6 I cap plus 2 by root 6 J cap. And further, that is 2 root 6 is there. 2 gets cancels. Okay, by taking that one. Plus 1 by root 6 K. You have to remember and solve. These type of problems may be asked. Further, he may ask, he will give the 3 points. He will give the 3 points. For example, is given A 1 1 1, B 1 2 3, C 2 3 1. Show that these are area of the, find the area of the triangle whose vertices are given. Now, what is the first step is, let O be the origin, I cap, comma J cap, comma K cap be the unit vector tried along the axis. Compulsory step when they are given point. What is the point? Let O be the fixed point, otherwise the O be the origin and I cap, J cap, K cap will be the unit vector tried along the axis. Then what you are going to get? OA bar is equal to, you are going to get OA bar is equal to I plus J plus K, and OB bar is equal to what you are going to get? OB bar is equal to 1, that is I plus 2J plus 3K, and OC bar what you are going to get? OC bar is equal to 2I plus 3J plus K. Now what you have to find? AB bar and AC bar. AB bar is equal to OB bar minus OA bar. Finally, what you are going to get? This one is J plus 2K. And AC bar is equal to what you are going to get? OC bar minus OA bar. That what you are going to get? This one is the I plus 2J. Now that means what you know? First find the AB cross AC. AB cross AC is equal to det of I, J, K. Now what you are going to get here? 0, 1, 2, 1, 2, 0. Then you are going to get, this one is the minus 4i plus 2j minus k. Now find the AB cross, that is det of the AB cross AC. Now det of AB cross AC, what you are going to get, observe there. Det of AB cross AC, det of AB cross AC. Det of AB cross AC is equal to what you are going to get? Root of 4 square, 16 plus 4 plus 1, that is nothing but root of 21. Hence, area of the required triangle, area of required triangle, what do you know? Half into modulus of AB cross AC, that is nothing but what you are going to get? Half into root of 21 square units. Like this, he may ask A bar is equal to 3i plus j plus 4k, b bar is equal to I minus j plus k. Find the area of the parallelogram whose adjacent sides are this one. Just find the a bar cross b bar. If you find the a bar cross b bar, you are going to get 5i plus j minus 4k. After that one, what is the area of the parallelogram? Modulus of AB cross AC, find that one. You are going to get root of 42 square units. This is the sum of the examples regarding that one. Next one is, find a unit vector, if a unit vector makes an angles of pi by 3 with I cap and pi by 4 with J cap, then find the theta with k cap, then find the value of k. That means I cap means what is that? I cap is the unit vector along x axis. J cap means what you know? Unit vector along y axis. And k cap is unit vector along z axis. That means the vector makes an angle of alpha, beta, gamma with the coordinate axis. Then what do you have? Cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to 1. That means here is given alpha is equal to pi by 3, comma beta is equal to pi by 4 and gamma is equal to theta. Then what you can write now? Cos pi by 3. Cos pi by 3 is a 1 by 2 whole square plus cos pi by 4, 1 by root 2 whole square plus cos square theta is equal to 1. And is mentioned theta is acute angle. That means we should get the first value only you have to take. Now 1 by 2 square is the 1 by 4 and 1 by root 2 whole square is the 1 by 2. 1 by 4 plus 1 by 2 is the 3 by 2. Take 3 by 4 outside. If you have taken this is the 3 by 4, no? Take 3 by 4 outside. 3 by 4 if you have taken outside, what you are going to get? Cos square theta is equal to 1 minus 3 by 4. Nothing but 1 by 4. Cos theta is equal to plus or minus 1 by 2. That is, theta is acute, no? Theta is acute. That's why theta is equal to what you are going to get? Theta is equal to you are going to get? Cos theta is equal to 1 by 2. Further, theta is equal to 60 degrees or pi by 3 radians. Now, here they are asked that components of the same vector they are asked. They are asked unit vector making an angles of pi by 3 with I cap and pi by 4 with J cap and theta be the acute angle with K cap. Then find the theta. Hence find the components. He is not mentioned anything. Components means vector component. That means actually what you know? A bar is equal to what you written? Cos alpha I cap plus cos beta J cap plus cos gamma K cap. Now what you are going to get therefore? A bar is equal to cos alpha. Cos alpha means what you know? 1 by 2 I cap, cos beta 1 by root 2 J cap and cos gamma 1 by 2 K cap. Now what are the components? Components of the A bar means nothing is mentioned. Components means consider the scalar component. That means components of the vector A bar is equal to 1 by 2 comma 1 by root 2 comma 1 by 2. Vector components means already we are discussing. Now what you are going to get? Vector components means 1 by 2 I plus 1 by root 2 J plus 1 by root 2 K cap. Okay, now further one more question here. What they are asked, observe there. They are asked that A bar and B bar vectors are such that modulus of A bar is equal to 3. Modulus of B bar is equal to root 2 by 3. Then find A cross B. Okay, sorry. A is given as the A bar is equal to 3 and B bar is equal to 2 by. And A bar cross B bar is a unit vector. This is a unit vector, then find angle between A bar cross A bar comma B bar. That means you have to find the theta, whatever the angle between them. Now here what is the formula we have? Actually what they are given? Modulus of A bar is equal to 3, modulus of B bar is equal to root 2 by 3, and here important one is the modulus of A bar cross B bar. What is that? A bar cross B bar is a unit vector, therefore we are going to get 1. Now sin theta is equal to what you are going to get? Sin theta is equal to modulus of A bar cross B bar by modulus A bar, modulus B bar. Now what you are going to get? Modulus of A bar is 1 by 3 into root 2 by 3. 3, 3 gets cancelled. You are going to get 1 by root 2. Therefore, sin theta is equal to 1 by root 2 means theta is equal to 45 or pi by 4 radians. So you have to remember that one. And the same type of question what you have studied in the previously in the dot product. Here that type of question. Either A bar is equal to 0 bar or B bar is equal to 0 bar. Then what they are given? A bar cross B bar. But converse show that is the converse of it was true, then justify the answer. That means converse is true or false and justify the answer they are asked. That means already in the severe previously what we have discussed, if two vectors are parallel or collinear, then angle between the what is the product A bar cross B bar is equal to 0 bar. That is here what I am getting observed there. Converse need. What is the converse you have to write? First converse. If A bar cross B bar is equal to 0 bar, then either A bar is equal to 0 bar or B bar is equal to 0 bar. Converse of the given statement. What is the solution now? Is need not to be true. Is need not to be true. Since here what I am taking, need not to be rest, you are written. Now what is the justification answer? Write the A bar is equal to I plus 2j plus 3k. You are written. For example, now multiply with 2 or 3 whatever it may be. I am multiplying with B bar is equal to 2i plus 4j plus 6k. That means I am taking scalar multiple of this vector. Now go for the A bar cross B bar, what you are going to get? Observe there, you know? A bar cross B bar is equal to, what you are going to get? I, J, K, 1, 2, 3, 2, 4, 6. Now, this is if you want to expand, otherwise, use the vector properties. Here, for your convenience, I am expanding. Actually, if you have taken 2 common, 2 rows are equal, then it is equal to 0. But I am writing I cap into what you are going to get? 6 are 12 minus 4, 3 is 12 minus J cap into what you are going to get? 6, 1 is 6, 2, 3 is 6. Plus K cap into what you are going to get? 1, 4 is 4, 2, 2 is 4. That means I into 0, K into 0, J into 0 means 0 bar. That is A bar cross B bar. Now clearly observe there. What is the modulus of A bar you are going to get? You are taken modulus of A bar is 1, 2, 3. No? 1, 2, 3 means here squaring on both sides. What you are going to get? That is the root of 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square. That is nothing but root of 14. And modulus of B bar, what you are going to get? Observe there. 2 square plus 4 square plus 6 square. That is nothing but what you are going to get? This one, observe there. 20, 56, root of 56. Both are non-zero vectors, but a product is become zero. That means the converse of the given statement is need not to be true. Further, here one more example. Here this type of question are usually asking for the 3 marks. Now they are given as A bar is equal A bar comma B bar comma C bar are 3 vectors satisfying A bar plus B bar plus C bar is equal to 0 bar. Then evaluate the quantity. That means they are given mu is equal to A bar dot B bar plus B bar dot C bar plus C bar dot A bar. If modulus of A bar is equal to 1, modulus of B bar is equal to 4 and modulus of C bar is equal to 2, then find mu value. You have to find now. Simply what they are given, A bar plus B bar plus C bar is equal to, they are given 0 bar. Now multiply with A bar on both sides. What you are going to get? A bar dot A bar plus B bar plus C bar is equal to A bar dot 0 bar. Now this is A bar plus A bar dot B bar plus A bar dot C bar is equal to 0 bar. Now here A bar dot A bar nothing but modulus of A bar square plus A bar dot B bar plus A bar dot C bar is equal to 0 bar. Now modulus of A bar square. What is the modulus of A bar? 1 square. 1 square means 1 take 1 outside. Therefore what you are going to get? A bar dot B bar plus A bar dot C bar is equal to minus 1. Similarly, multiplying with B, multiplying with C, you are going to get A bar dot B bar plus B bar dot C bar is equal to, here it is the 4, 4 square is 16 minus 16 and B bar dot C bar plus C bar dot A bar. Then what you are going to get? Here it is modulus of C bar square is, modulus of C bar is 2 square is 4 minus 4. Now adding these equations 1, 2, 3, A bar plus B bar, you are getting a 2 into A bar dot C bar, A bar dot C bar, B bar dot C bar and B bar dot C bar. That means 2 into A bar dot B bar plus B bar dot C bar plus C bar dot A bar is equal to what you got? Observe there, minus 21 you got. Finally, what is this actually? This is the mu. Mu is equal to, taking outside, minus 21 by 2. You have to remember, this is a miscellaneous example problem. Thank you.